popular civic education teacher during this stay at home, which we are believing you are staying safe. So, state government has made it possible for this e-learning activity so that your holiday, your compulsory holiday, will be rewarding, will not be a waste of time. So, we want to connect you with school. Today, we are going to look at another topic. But before you go to that topic, we want to look briefly at what we did during the previous lesson. During the last lesson, we look at the human rights. Human rights. And remember, we said that human rights are inalienable, fundamental freedoms and liberties that every free citizen is or should enjoy because he's a human being. Remember? You also said that human rights add value to human life. Also, we discussed that without human rights, human life cannot be valuable. So, human rights is valuable because of fundamental human rights. Human rights is respected because of fundamental human rights. And remember, we said that human right is egalitarian. Egalitarian in the sense that it is equal for everybody, whether you are rich or you are poor. You are educated, you are illiterate. You are from royal house or you are from unknown house. Human right is the same for everybody. We also said it is universal. Human right is the same everywhere. You can leave Nigeria, go to UK, or you go to Norway, or you go to Canada. The same human right should be accorded to you. So, human rights is very important. We also said that it is a pillar. Remember, it is a pillar to civilize culture and society. Thank God Nigeria is a civilized culture and society. That's why we enjoy our fundamental human rights. So today, we are going to look at limitations to human rights. What are those limitations to human rights? What is the limit to which I can claim my rights? What is the level to which I can assign my rights under the law? Remember, law is what guides us. Remember, law is what everybody should subscribe to. Law is above everybody. So under the law, what are the limitations to our fundamental human rights? One, when the right of another person is being encroached upon, that is the limit of your own rights. The level to which you can swing your hand, look at my hand. You want to swing your hand to assert your right, to claim your right. Somebody is standing nearby. He will defend his nose so that your hand will not cut his or hit him. That is the limit to which you can claim that right. So number one, we said that when the fundamental right of another citizen is threatened, that is the limit of your rights. Not say because you want to claim your right, you are encroaching upon the right of fellow citizens. The law will not allow that. For example, I'm driving my car on the highway. And I know that I'm not the only person who has the right to use that public good. Within the town, I'm driving at the speed of 90 kilometers per hour, which is dangerous to pedestrians and to other road users, like motorcyclists, like bicyclists. By the time you are doing that, you can hit another person. Or a little child is crossing the road mistakenly, you hit and kill him. You not say because you have the right to drive on the highway and destroy the life of others. That is the limitation to your right. There are other examples which I will refer to you to in your constitutional book or your textbooks, but I will still recommend the constitution. I will show you their brief passion when I finish this class. Then again, when the country is undergoing serious crisis, for example, if there is a crisis in particular part of a country, there is a problem. When a country is having crisis in one part of its territory, there is a problem. Like for instance, look at the Boko Haram that has started ravaging this country since 2009. Up to now, we don't know when it will end. All the citizens of Nigeria that are within that northeastern state, some states like Borno, Yobe, Adamawa, Bauchi, Gombe, and Taraba. They are in trouble. Most of their children could not go to school, even when there was no war in the country. But because that part of the country is having that insurgents, many citizens were deprived of their rights. Many could not go to their farms. Many were displaced. They lost their property. Some lost their loved ones, their relatives. So that is when the fundamental human rights of another person will be encroached or citizen, when there is a crisis in the country. Another circumstance through which the human right can be limited is when the country is threatened by war. When the country is threatened by war, when there is a war in any part of this country, there is a problem. Citizens will have their rights violated. Citizens cannot enjoy their rights as expected. Citizens cannot have liberties of movement or doing their business or going through their normal ways of life because of the war. Many of us maybe were killed that time, or many, some of you were not born that time, but if you ask your uncle, ask your father, during the Biafra war, ask some of them that were into the army, that went for the war, to prosecute the war, and some of our Eastern brothers and sisters that suffered the war, they will tell you, the grown-up one, the elderly one, they will tell you that war is not good. So anytime there is a war, citizens will lose their rights. In fact, some of the university undergraduates at that time were recruited into army by force to go and fight in the war. So they lost their fundamental human right to enjoy their education, even as at a tender age. Even secondary school students at that time were recruited into force to go and prosecute the war. Another condition through which a citizen can forfeit his right is when the fundamental human right of another person is being curtailed. Like, for instance, you just decide, because of little quarrel, you decide you pull out your gun because you have license to hold gun. Or maybe you are a soldier man. You came to the city or you went to the market to buy something. Little argument, you gun that person down. That's a murder. Because you have taken life, you yourself must lose your life. Your life will also be taken. So when you take the life of fellow citizen, intentionally, not accidentally, intentionally, you kill another person, fellow citizen, that is a crime against the state. It's a civil case, and it will not be taken lightly. You and your husband, your wife and husband, sometimes there may be very hot arguments. Don't be pushed to the level to which you will take harm and kill your spouse. The law will not say it is your wife. You are a killed human being. And the penalty for killing a woman being under the law, it is regarded as murder, and the penalty is death. We have had cases of that. So we have to be careful the way we go about our way of life and the way we conduct ourselves in the society. Another instance through which a citizen can lose or forfeit his fundamental human right is when a person is suffering from a disease. Somebody is suffering from a disease. That person will not be allowed to move freely. Like, for instance, an insane person, a madman. Students, I hope you are following me. A madman will not be allowed to move freely within the town, to move freely among the people, to move freely within the populace. No, because he has lost his senses. It's not with his mental faculty again. He can kill. And when a madman kill, you cannot sentence a madman because he's not with his senses. That's why if somebody is suffering from a terrible disease like a mental illness, he will be confined to asylum where he's going to be taken proper care of before he can be released to mix with the crowd. So another situation where citizens can forfeit his right is when there is a serious disease within the community. The people that are affected by that disease will be quarantined. They will be confined to a particular place so that the disease will not spread to the healthy citizen. There are many other instances where citizens can forfeit their rights, just for a while. Another instance that can make a citizen to forfeit his right Like, for instance, you have the right of freedom of expression, freedom of speech. You have your tongue, you have your mouth. You can talk anyhow, but there's a limitation. There is a limitation. We not say because you have your rights to speak anyhow, you abuse person of government, or you accuse them wrongly. You say something that is fallacious, something that is not right, something that is a lie against your fellow citizen, irrespective of his status. And that person now took it upon himself, instead of confronting you, because he's more intelligent, he's more civilized, he goes to court, that you are trying to destroy his character. If you are found guilty, that is what you refer to as an assault. And there is a punishment for that under the law. You don't speak lies of another fellow citizen. If you are not sure of your facts, be quiet. Another way through which your right of expression can be contained is when you write something in the newspaper, or you go to the radio house or television and publish lies. Maybe it's your political opponent, and you are not sure of the facts, just to defame his character, just to assassinate his character. You went and published nonsense, lies against him. That is another serious crime. That is a libel. Will be punished accordingly under the law. Another instance under which a citizen can forfeit their right is when a citizen's property is being encroached upon. Like, for instance, before you build your house, there is a law you have to abide with under the Urban Development Authority. If you are building your house, it should be free from power line. You all know what is called power line. Your house should not even be very close to power line. It should be very far, far away. If your house is very close or under the power line, you are endangering the life of yourself, your family, and other people. So such property under the law, you forfeit it. You forfeit your right of owning the property because you sighted your house under the power line. Another instance that you can lose your right to acquire property is that when you are to build your house, there's a road, main road, or access road within the town. The law says that you should build a house 10 meters away from the road. If your house is about 8 meters of the road, you are guilty of offense. And the state government or the authority can destroy that property without giving you compensation. But when the town was laid, when the normal layout was done, there was not that law. That road was not a really big road, it was just ordinary passage. And your house is very close. Then because of development that is coming up, government decided to dualize the road, to make it a major road now. Of course, people property will be encroached upon, right and left. Government will not be so foolish and rush your house with bulldozer, no. They will go back to the major original plan and see that your house, we make sure that your house, we make sure that you are not denied of your property. Maybe that property belongs to your great-grandfather, belongs to your great-grandfather. Government will now mark it. You see the Red Cross. I'll give you an example. That Badaria road, that Makra road that passed through the Nagiri College, down to the village. When government was to construct that road, what it is that all those houses that are very close to the road, without minding whether it was in original plan or not, they gave them a lot of money, enough money, to make sure that they can acquire another property. Government gave them money to make sure they can acquire another property. That's the way of government encroaching upon your rights. Government will compensate you adequately. They don't want you to suffer ordinarily. Because the government knows that you have the right to acquire your property under the law. So government will not want to run foul of that law. So these are some of the limitations to our fundamental human rights. These are the various limitations to fundamental human rights. I will go over it again so that it will sink to your subconsciousness as you are growing up. You grow up as a civilized, as law-abiding youngsters and responsible adults. The first one, you have the right of to claim your rights. You have liberty to express yourself. You have the liberty to enjoy your rights, but the limit of enjoying that right, the limit of asserting that right, is the extent, or the extent to which you can assert that right, is the limit where another person will stand up for his rights. Hello, students. I hope you are getting me. The extent to which you can claim your rights is the limit to other person's rights. So you stop doing that. When the country is undergoing serious crisis, even this Corona 19 is a sort of crisis. This Corona 19 is a sort of crisis that we're undergoing. We didn't plan for it. It came suddenly. So most of us are not enjoying our freedom of movement, freedom of going to school to acquire education. We have to stay at home to save life and to make sure that the country is not destroyed by this disease. So under that situation, your right will be subverted. Your right will be curtailed. Your right will be denied you, not intentionally, just to save life. Another situation under which your right can be encroached upon is when public peace is being threatened. When public peace is being threatened, under that circumstance, you are going to forfeit your rights. A madman that is sick is a danger to society. It's a danger to himself. It's a danger to the next person around him. So government will not allow such a person because it's a danger to the peace. It's a danger to the life of other fellow citizens. So he will be taken to the asylum where he will be attended to medically. You lose your right under that circumstance. Another one is that when a country is undergoing war, you don't pray for war. We have had situations where Nigeria has to go to war in the 60s, and many lives and properties were lost. Up to today, those people lost their property forever. Nothing to, nowhere to claim it. So when a country is under the war, citizens are going to...